assigned to physics instead of multi-visitors, because I think there's another thing that we can take away in terms of experience, customer services, and also the excellent product. Another reason is that we have the policy of reaching out to our customers. Cabinet Electric is no more PSCM. In the past, when somebody mentioned NEPA or PSCM, all you think is poor services, extortion, you know, and then bad customer response. But now, there's a complete change of environment, complete change of business model, and a complete output in terms of how we do business. We're a normal government, so we're businessmen and a privately owned company. So our objective is to ensure that we deliver a good quality service so that our customers will be quite happy, and then they can also recognize us. Our plan being a company here in Kaduna, it's also our policy to see what areas can we support companies, because we cannot export this power. Our business is power distribution and retail. We are not in the business of generation. So if we are in the business of distribution and retail, the most important is to ensure that we provide the services to our customers. And part of also our policy is to ensure that the companies that are operating, you know, are quite confident in terms of our services, and we can have very good feedback. And the reason why we're listening is to have a feedback in terms of our services. In the past, nobody cares about that. We are a customer, we have to be chasing the utility company or the service provider. But now, since we are a customer-centric company, the idea is to hear out the customer, what are their issues, the challenges, how we can improve our services. You know, just mention a few in terms of quality of voltage, you know, regular supply. Because we cannot hold this power. Once it's generated, transmitted, and distributed, either goes to customer that pays or to a customer that doesn't pay. So if you have a paying customer, what is more important is ensure that you push more power to the customer so that you can get your money. So that is our own focus, and that is where we are looking at all industries and supporting. At the end, you mentioned the history of years old, 5 years old, you know, feature. And that's the car they go to launch. And you mentioned about the size of the company in the past, and then in terms of over 4,000, you know, employees in the company, over 300. And the new management that has come in, definitely with the experience of the managing director, which I met before, definitely is going to turn around the company to ensure that there's efficiency. The many people get employment and the product to definitely sell. Because I know he gives in quality and then the standard of the product. So I know that plan will definitely have an edge over other companies. From our own side, the only way we can support that is to ensure that the services that you require, we are able to give it to you on time. Because you mentioned about the rest of these companies were efficient, they wouldn't have been prioritized. You know, we have entered the company good, bad, and ugly. So our own objective is to straighten things, to ensure that we can operate efficiently, our customers, you know, be happy with our services, and we can also generate some revenue that we'll be able to expand and invest. That is the major objective, and that is our business plan. We've taken over in about 7 to 8 months now. So we've been listing some of our customers, some of our facilities, carrying out detailed studies to ensure which area we need to improve. we have had a due diligence in the past, but it's different from what we actually met on the ground, because in the past we were not able to have full access. But now we are in the system, we know where it reaches, and the whole idea is to ensure that all our customers are happy. The unfortunate thing is that you do not receive enough power that we really distribute. Normally, Kaduna as a zone should have at least a minimum of 8% of total generation in the country. If we have 3,000 to 2,500 megawatts, we'll be looking at between 280 to 300 megawatts. But in the past, we have 80 megawatts, 120, 150. Now there's a little improvement of about 200 megawatts. But 200 megawatts is not even sufficient for Kaduna metropolis. You know, metropolis of Kaduna, Sokoto, Kebbi, and sometimes we have to see this power. I think one of the reasons why sometimes the power is not consistent, and then there's load shedding, you know, all that, to ensure that we touch every corner. So that at least, but we are looking beyond what is being generated and transmitted. We're also looking at the time to source of power, so that we can have captive power or in the regeneration. Customers that are key, we can drop a power plant around that cluster, so that they can have continuous supply 24 hours. So we are looking at that option. We're also collaborating with the state government to ensure that we have more power in the system. So it's part of our effort. And then the other part is that we believe if we make a realistic investment, we will create opportunities. And it's one of the reasons why now we embark on the recruitment exercise. As part of the change process that we try to not only on equipment, the challenges we make is not based on nature of attitude. It's also an issue of attitude of staff that we have inherited, which we believe some are trainable, some we cannot train them. So for us to be able to be efficient and also to continue operations, we have to bring in people that we can help us get where we want to go. Recently, we have received applications over 60,000, over 9,000 attended aptitude tests, over 6,000 participated in the interview. So our plan is to actually recruit minimum of about 3,000 staff. So that at least in terms of response, you know, if we have an issue with any customer, we have personnel that are well trained to respond to customers' needs. You know, in terms of regular meeting with the customer, understanding the challenges and issues, and also if there are some technical issues, somebody will be there. At the moment, we don't have that, but we're trying to improve. And in the next 3 weeks to 4 weeks, we'll complete the recruitment exercise, and then our guys will be in the field to support our customers. So that's why we embark on this process. At the same time, as the MD said, it's also part of our corporate social responsibility. We are operating in this area. And the large chunk of the people that we are going to put this for this part of the country. They know the terrain, and they should also understand that they are mixing with the people that they came from. So in terms of integrity, prudent, honesty, it has to be there for us to operate. So this is who we are and what we are trying to do. And as I said, the visit is also to understand what can we do for Japan, and also how we can collaborate, and we also understand the product. You mentioned some items which interest us, especially the van mission. Since we are in the process of bringing more people to the system, we need working tools, we need mobile workshop. So we need a rapid response team. So we believe such a project, I think, can head our plans. be very